And so as we go forth and begin our annual meeting, I found this wonderful old book in the sacristy called It's a Treasury of Inspiration. And this is a chapter, a little piece called Faith Kills Fear. And I thought it was appropriate not only for what we're dealing with on a global level and a national level, but also as this community moves through its year of transition. The mind dominated by fear opens the door for the entrance of the very things, for the actualization of the very conditions it fears. "Where are you going?" asked an Eastern pilgrim on meeting the plague one day. "I'm going to Baghdad to kill 5,000 people." A few days later, the same pilgrim met the plague returning. "You told me you were going to Baghdad to kill 5,000 people," said he, "but instead you killed 50,000. "No," said the plague, "I killed only 5,000, as I told you I would. The others died of fright." Fear can paralyze every muscle in the body. Fear affects the flow of the blood, likewise the normal and healthy action of all the life forces. Fear can make the body rigid, motionless, and powerless to move. Not only do we attract to ourselves the things we fear, but we also aid in attracting to others the conditions we, in our own minds, hold them in fear of. This we do in proportion to the strength of our own thought and in the degree that they are sensitively organized and so influenced by our thought. And this, although it be unconscious, both on their part and on ours. And so go forth into the world in the resurrection, in the strength of Christ. Claim the faith that is within us. Claim that vision for this church that God wills. And so may that peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all for whom you pray this day and always. Amen.